Hey, what's going on? Welcome. I'm Logan Sam, your host. Thank you very much for joining us throughout 2021. This is a special video because it's this year in Grime, 2021. What a year it's been. We all thought that we're going to be back outside. We're going to be back enjoying everything. We're all going to get back to normal. That hasn't been the case. But you know what? I am so, so very proud of all of the Grime community coming together. I'm still making incredible things happen all throughout this year. We're going to be running down some of the most popular events to happen this calendar year. And obviously, there's been a lot to pick from. This is just a selection thereof. Big up everybody who's been active this year, whether it's, you know, selling out tours, putting out album projects, or even just, you know, releasing your first single, doing your first video. From top to bottom, you have been responsible for keeping this scene going, especially in the times that we've been having and how important it has been. And big up to the listeners, the supporters, the fans as well, because if you were not consuming this stuff that we are doing here in the scene that we love to make and love to give to you, then we won't be able to carry on doing it either. So big up everyone. This is a celebration of the year. Feel free, of course, to drop some of your favorite things that happened in 2021 down below in the comments. But let's not delay any further. Let's get into this year in Grime.
And listen, the album is up. Nah, you man, I don't know what we're saying.
Go get that.
You know what? It would be literally impossible to put together a list of the biggest things to happen this year from the Grime scene and not have multiple things from Big Zoo in there. So you know what we did? We just lumped it all together. We are going to be celebrating Big Zoo's 2021, and what an incredible year it's been. You know, we've seen him grow and build. He's a great artist. We saw him debut on TV with Big Zoo's Big Eats, but this year he has gone from strength to strength. Another season confirmed, award nominated, BAFTAs. We saw him play at Soccer Aid. We saw him launch campaigns with Pret & Manger. We saw him launch campaigns with Giacomo. He's been all over the place. And most importantly, he launched his debut solo album. Let's take a look at some of the other things he's done in this jam-packed year.
Not known from his tackling. Giving a spill, giving a lowdown, can't lie. They don't want beef. Give them a rap, there's no meat. How about this ain't doing one takes no more?
Sounds of the sir. I've been on motions. Levels on my soul, rock hitting up the potions.
Packed up my van and I drove out to Vegas and asked Dana White to set up Steve-O versus Justin Bieber.
Alright, congratulations, man. Zoo, we're all so proud of you. You've had an incredible year. I know you're not going to rest on your laurels and take it easy in 2022. I can't wait to see what you give us. We spent the majority of 2021 hoping, praying for the day that we could get back out and enjoy Grime how it's meant to be enjoyed. Live, in the clubs, within touching distance of some of your favorite artists. And you know what? We finally got that with JME's Grime MC FM at Fabric. What an incredible night this was for Grime. We were so hungry for this live experience. And Jamie, of course, delivered with a star-studded name of artist in one of the most famous nightclubs in the country. This really kicked off what has been an incredible couple of months of live events. And, you know, big up Jamie and the team once again. Big up all the artists that were involved. It was an incredible night.
Me, but they like me. They go, they get them, but they like me. Because I'm a stick and shoot them.
The existence of the Igloo studio space certainly motivated many, many people in a time in which a lot of hope and motivation was lost. It was incredibly difficult for artists to come together, get in the studio and make things happen. But the Igloo studio was certainly responsible for that. Big up the full team down there, Wiley, Janaya, everybody involved, K9, and of course the full studio team as well. There's been some incredible music that has been born of that, and I know there's much, much more to come. But for me, that's definitely one of the highlights of the year, one of the most important things to happen.
I say that, sitting over speaking.
Once the clubs reopened, it was time for Grime to shine once again, and big up everybody who managed to get nights off and provide that essential experience for Grime fans around the country to attend and enjoy this music as it was meant to be intended. But one of the most legendary names when it comes to live Grime events has to be Eskimo Dance, and they return with a double header event, two nights, two cities, this Halloween. It was Eskimo Dance in Croydon Box Park and Eskimo Dance in Bristol, the O2. Two great nights, and let's take a look at some of the footage that we captured from that. It's been a great year for international grime. We've seen grime out of Eastern Europe. We've seen grime out of Japan. But for me, one of the most exciting things of the year was to see grime emerge out of Brazil in such a strong way. And I think for me, the pinnacle of that had to be the BRIME EP, which saw Butterz link up with Brazilian talent to create this EP of music. A fusion between the sounds of grime and biofunk, it saw producers Cesar, Fleezus and Febum work tirelessly in the studio to put together this project, and the vinyl sold out. Shout out to the Butterz crew as well, celebrating 10 years of live events, a real legendary label. And big up for them for putting together projects like this, man. I love to see international grime. I can't wait to see and hopefully experience in person more international grime in 2022. One of the biggest releases of the year was definitely the collaborative project between JME, Frisco, Shorty and Capo Lee linking up under the collaborative name of North Face. Gotta get more. Man, see blessings, gotta get more. The EP saw these North London MCs come together with a very innovative format, which included both full tracks and shorter freestyles on the project. It was incredibly well received. The videos were great. There was a lot of hype around it. We even got to see some live shows as North Face headlined a couple of events towards the end of the year. And generally, collaborations like this get us all excited. It definitely got you excited, and that's why it's here on the list. P Money's had a great year. He linked up with Star One to work on a vegan promotional project for Subway. He became the first ever grime artist to be signed by an esports organization, and he has been diving into the world of No Pixel recently. But his collaborative EP with Teddy Music, aka Silencer, the Untraditional EP, that really got you guys' attention. Yo, you don't want trouble. COVID flow and a busman's bubble. Continuing a successful partnership, we've seen a number of great singles arise, produced by Teddy. The Untraditional EP saw a 9-track project put together, and of course, everything was Silencer beats. With leading singles This Year and Trouble getting everyone hype, it was single Stuttering, which saw a legendary link up featuring Chip, DEE, and Dizzy Rascal. Black taxi mode when I'm pissed off, heads getting picked up and ripped off. Well, up front for my team when they lick shots, I'm right there in the center when it kicks off. 9 tracks of absolute flyer. It was definitely one of the hottest releases on the scene in the year, and that is why it made the list. I don't want to hear your shit songs, your baby food, your shit's off. This is not a rap.
First of all, I want to thank Ultra Haze. I want to thank Alhan for putting this on. This has been a fuck.
After announcing potentially his last ever project as an MC, All In from Skepta saw him take over the Hippodrome's Casino for the launch event. And this was particularly momentous because never before have cameras been allowed inside at that event.
Let's see how low your cojones hang, my guy.
Shout out to the Ultra Haze team for putting it together as well. It was an incredible night. A who's who of the UK music industry came together and enjoyed such incredible tracks such as Eyes on Me, Nirvana and Peace of Mind. But it was the incredible launch party that got everybody talking, with some strong arguments for Skepta becoming the next James Bond. We'll see what happens with that. But hopefully it doesn't prove to be Skepta's last project and we get lots more out of him in 2022. But this was certainly very exciting. It got you guys talking and that is why it is on our year in review list.
For my brothers in the grave and my dogs on the wing. Disrespect my that's a cardinal sin. Walking to...
Ghetts has had a truly incredible career and his transition, his journey from one of the most dangerous mic men in the game to a truly world-class artist and musician has been sensational. Part of that has been his dedication to becoming one of the finest live performers in the game. And we saw him once again take over the Roundhouse to perform his Conflict of Interest album. The album was an absolute smash, nominated in multiple categories and winning awards. But getting to see this album performed live was a truly spiritual performance. Having experienced Kano headlining at the Royal Albert Hall, I have to say that this is definitely up there alongside that in terms of epic performances, and that is why it definitely cruises in to our top stories of 2021. As I said, that is just a selection of some of the most popular events. That doesn't mean that they're the best things to happen in the year. It doesn't mean that they have eclipsed and overshadowed everything else that happened. It just means that they were the most popular on our website. I know there's going to be things that are more popular with you guys. I know there's going to be things that resonated more with you guys out there this year. And it's incredible to say that there's been so many epic moments in Grime in 2021 with all the restrictions, you know, and all of the barriers in place to stop us from doing that. But we have strived, we have, you know, we've pushed on and we have created some incredible moments, some true greatness that will live far beyond the year of 2021. I'm very proud of everything everyone has achieved. Thank you so much. If you've done anything this year within the grime scene, I hope to see you in 2022. Do even more, elevate even further. We're going to be back right here at Keeping It Grimy, doing our best to support where and when we can. And as always, man, if you've got anything coming out, anything grime related, hit us up on the email. We will be happy, happy to promote your stuff here on the website, the home of grime, the home of grime news. And I'll be back for the first Monday of the year for This Week in Grime, the first episode of 2022. But until then, take care. And as always, make sure you keep it grimy.